Besides, they also you are labeling women as some kind of a burden. If you heard what Abhay Chautala said, that somehow without getting a letting your family member get raped, we have to make sure she goes to another house. So it's some kind of a social and moral burden that you carry on yourself.
That's right. And if one goes by these statements of the cop whoever else is saying, then someone else is going to, the next statement is going to be, well, now, 16 years is not enough. We might as well confine them at home. Going by that logic. So where does it end? You can't keep regressing.
And what's more important is that you're victimizing the woman who was raped.
In this particular case, let's get Vinod Kumar Tikku in. Vinod Kumar Tikku, your hands must be tied once again. You're a member of the NCPCR, but you have a former chief minister making a strong case for underage marriage. What do you think?
This is really very unfortunate that we have to listen to this kind of a statement in the 21st century, and in the days that we talk of India becoming a superpower, especially in Haryana. I've been working with them very closely for the past 2 years. And we have been basically, telling them time and again that they have been using children, especially girl child, abusing them, molesting them. They've been all kind of, it's not just, denying them freedom. They're being denied every right that a girl needs to have, whether it's education, whether it's healthcare, whether it is, participating in the social activities. Nothing is being allowed to them. They're being time and again denied, and we have been vehemently fighting this with the government of Haryana. Even at times, what happened in the last 2 months of May.
Mr. Tikku, are political parties scared of cops?
5 years.
Say this. Open up tonight. Being a member of the NCPCR.
It looks like yes, they are. But then the cop, as a member of the
party, scared of cops, or are they hand in league with cops? Tell me.
The commission has very vehemently statement about the cops. Every time we have been saying it against the cops, that the cops should not be allowed to function like this. They are actually denying every right of the child, especially the girl in Haryana. And Haryana, we consider to be a sort of a,
economically forward. No, but Mr. Tikku, there's no point saying it. I think it's time to utter a few uncomfortable truths. Yes, Ms. Singh.
I am saying that. I've said very well that yes, cops should not be allowed to function at all. Not at all. No political party should allow that.
Well, they are functioning, and they are functioning happily. And they are also saying that unless they are almost condoning, what has happened, they are supporting the rapes by saying that poor children,
these
poor boys with uncontrollable sexual libido, and girls, if they are not married by the age of 16, they will go out and carry out rapes. It's almost a justification of the act of rape. Kirti Singh, yes, what were you saying?
How would you justify rape of the female adult?
And they don't want to do anything against the rapist. Sorry. They don't want to do anything against the rapist.
The rapist will have to be severely punished.
They want to ask the girl to get married and be abused further.
That is absolutely ridiculous.
This is the unfortunate situation.
That's barbaric. That's inhumane. I mean, we are in advanced stage of 21st century where we are taking India to some other heights, and we cannot be going back on 60 years down the lane and then saying that we have to make a girl get married at 14 or 15.
Well, we have gone back today 300 to 400 years because Om Prakash Chautala is talking about what happened during Mughal rule. I don't understand this logic and why this country and its top politicians are scared to question things openly. And why politicians like Abhay Chautala, when asked two straight questions, run away from the news hour and not take those questions. Yes, Kirti Singh, I want you to complete your point. Yes, Ms. Singh.
Yes, the point that I was making is they have nothing to talk about the rapist. They don't say, let's catch hold of this person, let's subject him to the maximum punishment that he is under the law that should be given to him. They don't talk about what's happening to the girl and her family. They don't say that you are not to blame, please don't commit suicide. I mean, the girl and her family should be given immediate counseling, medical help, and police help. And they are not talking about these issues. They are talking of all kinds of extraneous things which will not help in any way. They are not talking about the fact that, you know, Haryana is going to be a state where we are going to make sure that these rapists are caught. And this is the astonishing part. And of course, they don't want to shut down the CAPS because of political reasons. We all know that. We all know that the government has refused to make a law on honor crime because it doesn't suit them, you know, in the state of Haryana. At the moment, the chief minister cannot think that he cannot disagree with the CAPS. So I think as far as human rights issues are concerned,
I want to give our young representative of the Haryana Youth Congress one more opportunity here tonight. Chiranjeev, tell me, take a position, hit the streets. Will you do that anti-CAP campaign, or are you also? What do you think about the position taken by your senior Congress leaders? Your senior Congress leader Hari Prasad read out the law. When he was asked, what is your position, he read out the law that below the age of 18, you should not marry. Is that the kind of weak response that is acceptable to you as a youth leader?
I think action should be taken against the CAP because the statement which he has given that marriage should be done below the age of 16.
We all know that. He's not being asked a general knowledge question.
Yeah.
So why is he avoiding the question in your view?
I think Mrs. Sonia Gandhi has also said the same thing, that that action should be taken against it, and the government has taken, and it has also said that fast track courts should do something against it.
No, but that's, you know, I don't want to get into stating the obvious here today. And may I put an uncomfortable statistic out? I want to come back to you, Vandana. This statistic goes out to everyone watching the news hour tonight. Since 1971, reported rape cases have gone up by 873% per year. Now we can decide what we want to do with it, Vandana. That is the crude statistic. If the people of this country need to wake up to it, since 1971 our economy grows up, I don't know how many percent, but the number of rape cases go up 873%. What's required, Vandana?
You see, Arnab, it's a breakdown of law and order. What is law and order? It is the physical, financial and emotional well-being of and security of every citizen. When there is a lag between the crime committed and action taken, you can't keep saying we will take action. When there is a lag between, then you are only encouraging people to commit more because they think we'll get away with it.
Absolutely.
And it is not just Haryana. I have to say, in Delhi has a woman chief minister, and when we were having the same problems here that were getting highlighted, her reaction, and with due respect
absolutely
to the work she's
go
done,
ahead.
Her reaction was that, well, women shouldn't step out at night. So, you know, we are talking about increasing security and safety. Now, by that logic, then you'll say women shouldn't step out at 9 o'clock. Now, women shouldn't step out after 7 o'clock. Now, women shouldn't step out at all.
Absolutely.
So, the point is law and order. The point is coming down with strong punitive actions, and as Kirti Singh said, it is important not to victimize the victim, because that we do, the society tends to do that. You victimize the victim, but if the law and order is strong and if political parties take a strong stance and start implementing punitive measures towards the culprits, then that tends to change.
Possibly.
That's our only hope, in fact.
Well, Kuldeep Singh Bishnoi, has rape been politicized in your state?
I can't hear you. Can you repeat it, please?
The short question
crime
was,
has not been
Mr. Bishnoi, has rape
yes?
been politicized in Haryana today?
Not at all. Rape is a very serious offense. How can it be politicized? It's not politicized at all.
I see only political brownie points on all sides being taken, and the graph of the number of rapes also increasing. I find the political charges and counter charges getting stronger. I see no united action being taken, and that's why I'm asking you, Mr. Bishnoi, has rape been politicized?
I am just saying the chief minister, Sonia Gandhi ji, at this point of time I can say it's politicized, because Sonia Gandhi went yesterday to meet one family of the rape, where rape has happened. Whereas 733 rapes has happened in last 9 months. She did not go anywhere. Why did she go yesterday? Because elections are happening in Himachal and Gujarat. Was she concerned for women of Haryana, women of India? She should have gone earlier, where rapes have been happening. 14 rapes have happened in just 1 month. She went to one place. It's a political thing because she wants to take political mileage in Himachal and in Gujarat. Same thing happened in Mirchpur when Dalit girl was burnt. Rahul Gandhi came to Mirchpur that time in Haryana because UP elections were happening. In between, so many things have happened. So many rapes have happened. So many Dalits have been burnt. Neither Sonia nor Rahul Gandhi. They visited Haryana. This is all political drama what Sonia did yesterday.
I won't join issue on that particular point with you, not on this show, but in a country where the number of rapes, it goes up by 873%, if all we see is becoming the subject of political debate and these cops get away with it, I think it's very, very worrying. Well, to Mr. Tikku, Vandana Kohli, Kirti Singh, Chiranjeev Rao, Kuldeep Bishnoi, and Mr. Abhay Chautala, who left before I could say thank you to him, thank you very much for joining me on the NewsHour debate tonight. Thank you very much.